And the solution is that all of these modes can be decrypted in parallel. So let's look at each one of these modes one at a time. ECB can be decrypted in parallel because for each CNOT that we have, we can decrypt it in reverse to end up with our original message. This can be run on one processor. We can do the same thing on this one and for all the other chunks of the message that we have. And all those can be run in parallel. Counter mode is also decryptable in parallel. For counter mode, the important part that we need to calculate is this bit into the XOR. And we know our NOTs and we know our counter in advance. So this whole chunk can be calculated on one processor. This whole chunk can be calculated on another processor, and so on. And once we calculate those, we can calculate our XORs to reverse the C1 into the message. And this can also all be done in parallel. For Cipher block chaining mode, similar to counter mode, the important part, this input into the XOR again, which for the first block, we know the initialization vector, so that can be calculated. Independently, we are already given C0, which can be processed in parallel to this part. In C1, we know, and this can be processed in parallel. And again, we can process, calculate this, and CBC can be decrypted in parallel. Similar to cipher block chaining mode, the cipher feedback mode is decryptable in parallel. The idea is very similar to the two modes we just discussed. We need to calculate the input into the XOR. This entire chain is known in advance. From CNOT, we have this entire chain, which is also known in advance, and we can calculate all these inputs into the XOR in parallel and decrypt our message.